let's be honest here, the memes are too good not to share, and we're not deserving of them, guys. Welcome back, beautiful and amazing human beings. This is Zuckerdowski of WeAreChange.org. Seems like today almost everyone is going to jail, as there's been a slurry of insane bureaucratic government action, which is criminalizing the most basic behavior, and it's becoming more prevalent by the day. Except, of course, if you do unspeakable things and traffic children while having friends like Bill Gates. But before we get into that, plus all the latest developments surrounding that particular case, Joe Biden, who once made fun of Donald Trump for walking up the stairs slowly, had a little mishap himself with the stairs, which of course everyone's talking about.
Look at how he steps and look how I step. Watch how I run up ramps and he stumbles down ramps, okay? Come on. Watch how I run up ramps and he stumbles down ramps, okay?
And now, of course, we're going to debate about this endlessly, with some people saying that this is a major big deal, some people saying it's not a big deal. And I'm just here really for the memes, which are pretty much on point right now, especially in the ridiculousness of this entire situation, as, of course, the Biden White House released a statement saying that it was windy outside. By and large, the mainstream media regurgitated a lot of these larger talking points. Social media even banned some users from posting videos and memes about this. And yeah, let's be honest, some of the memes are pretty amusing, like this one tweeted out by Don Jr. But in reality of the situation, of course, there's a lot more serious situations to discuss, like the Biden administration canceling funds for the construction of a border wall between the United States and Canada, while, of course, Democratic leadership in Congress are trying to get a $2 billion package for walls and security fencing around them from the American public. The irony is not lost here. And another policy that the Biden administration is putting their stamp of approval on is spraying the country of Colombia with glyphosate in order to fight the production of the coca plant. Yes, aerial spraying of poisons will now, under the pressure and approval of the Joe Biden administration, that some say will cause human and environmental harm, while, of course, according to some, being inefficient is something that the Biden administration fundamentally believes in. And while Biden stumbles, his agenda of the very powerful special interest elites and billionaire class is, of course, getting served, while mainly people are tuning out away from politics, because that's just usually what happens. As Biden's White House literally only had 1,000 people watching him and his speech. Kind of strange for the most voted for president in American history, but who am I to question it? Now, as the mainstream media carries water for Joe Biden and regurgitates any talking point that comes out or stumbles or mumbles out of his mouth, we here at We Are Change, we do things a little bit differently, since, of course, we're independent media. And because we're different, we definitely get treated very differently and need to rely on different monetization policies to still exist. One of the ways that we started doing it is through t-shirts and merchandise, which have been doing incredibly well at spreading messages and waking people up all across the world just by simply wearing a t-shirt, starting a conversation. We just got some brand new t-shirts that we can't even show you here. We have a lot of them. I even had to just slightly alter and censor my t-shirt for today to make sure that this video gets out there to the general public. And if you're interested in helping spread the message, inform random citizens about what's really going on, check out thebestpoliticalshirts.com. Click the link down in the description to see some of the stuff that we can't even show you here. Also, in related news, my speech and exclusive videos from Anarchapoco are now up right now on lukeuncensored.com. There will be a new video also today, which you could exclusively get by only going to lukeuncensored.com. I think it's just time enough to remind the American public that there still has not been any justice for the thousands of children hurt by Mr. Epstein, an individual with extremely close ties to the federal government that many argue aided and abetted his international trafficking operation of children for over 30 years. And still, to this day, not one person has been brought to justice in this entire case, in this entire scandal, when we know the federal authorities have countless numbers of photos and videos of all of Mr. Epstein's close friends, just like Bill Gates here. Is Bill Gates in some of these photos or videos? Well, we don't know. We don't know a lot, but the reason I'm bringing up this particular case is because there have been some very interesting developments surrounding the court case of Miss Ghislaine Maxwell, who has been known, according to some, to even be in a more higher-up position than Mr. Epstein himself. Now, the only latest developments surrounding Epstein are, of course, very trivial, like the fact that a former Goldman Sachs executive just bought his mansion in New York City that was used a part of a larger extortion operation with its own room dedicated to surveillance, as it was bugged with hidden cameras everywhere. Who would have thought that a mystery Goldman Sachs executive would be buying up the mansion where unspeakable things happened to children for $51 million. And now I know bankers have a reputation, but wow, this even far precedes them in just absolute ruthlessness trying to get a bargain. And it looks like a lot of other ruling elites, billionaires from the establishment class might be getting a bargain as well when it comes to, of course, actually facing the repercussions of their actions, as we're getting information that a federal judge in Manhattan just ruled a few days ago that some of the details in the ongoing Maxwell case are, quote, too sensitive and impure to be revealed to the public. Yes, according to Jerry Lambie of lawandcrime.com, a judge ruled that some of the details in this case are, quote, too sensational and impure to be revealed to the public. This, of course, according to Jerry Lambie from lawandcrime.com, who revealed that the judge in this case approved many important redactions by Ghislaine Maxwell and the prosecutors in this case, which of course will bury very important details to the general public about what actually happened here, because we still don't know. That's important to note here. The U.S. government asked to redact some information that Maxwell was objecting to, which also requested redactions on her behalf, which were granted. The U.S. government argued that it needed these redactions in order to, quote, protect the integrity of its ongoing criminal investigation and to, quote, protect the privacy interests of third parties. And the bigger question we have to ask ourselves, what is the government trying to redact from the American public that will protect its integrity, when of course many people already understand that the government was aiding and abetting a child trafficking operation? There's a reason we had an entire meme storm about this entire case, when of course the government, the mainstream media, and the establishment were trying to obfuscate it, making sure that no one was talking about it. Now, the little that we know about these redactions is that a name of a third party was redacted because, quote, his privacy interest outweigh the presumption of access that exists, and to hide information because some of the information will, quote, cater to an appetite for sensational and impure information to the general public is not a legitimate excuse, in my opinion. I don't care how sensational or impure some of the information is. The people involved in this case, involved with Mr. Epstein, deserve to be called out. The crazy things they did many times under the protection of the federal government deserves to be known, since, as we know here, there are many bigger implications than we actually even know about in this case that have huge implications for our social and political landscape. And to see Maxwell and the government being able to hide information from the general public is already extremely concerning about a very important court case that thousands of people were hurt because of, that are hoping for a little bit of justice. The details of what happened here are shocking, but the public deserves to know what happened, since, of course, their tax-paying dollars financed a lot of it. Now, when your taxes are going to obfuscate some of the worst horrendous crimes on the face of this earth, they're usually spent on criminalizing innocent behavior, as we recently learned from New Hampshire, where the FBI, who ignored the Epstein case for over 30 years, by the way, independent media was screaming about it, but the FBI for some reason was looking the other way the whole freaking time, the FBI, along with the IRS, decided to go after people in New Hampshire for the crime of operating a business with cryptocurrencies. As, of course, a libertarian radio talk show host, Ian Freeman, including with five other individuals, were arrested and are now being deemed the Bitcoin Six for using cryptocurrencies with their businesses. The federal government spared no expense, using, of course, morning raids with SWAT members to go after one of the first radio broadcasters to actually promote Bitcoin. There's actually a website talking about this situation that's called thecrypto6.com, where people could get involved and help out these individuals after being targeted by the FBI and the IRS for conducting business. They are also collecting money for their legal defense fund. And of course, we're going to be following this situation very closely, since according to many people, this is a travesty of injustice. Other injustices that are happening around this world is, of course, people being arrested and charged for violating made-up decrees by government officials like the mayor of New York City or the governor of New York, who is ruling with very inappropriate hot dog innuendos and an iron fist. In Pennsylvania, the government is going after a YouTuber who they arrested on 18 counts for, quote, yes, I kid you not, filming an epic jump on his own private property because he did it without a permit. In Ireland, a woman was arrested for traveling home for Mother's Day. Also, in the United Kingdom, police officers who previously ran the other way or took a knee for BLM protest just a few months ago decided to get rough with protesters protesting, of course, the lockdowns. We, of course, saw similar measures yesterday all over the world, as there were massive anti-lockdown protests all across the Western world, which in many instances were heavily policed, and in some instances, people were arrested for attending. In Michigan, a restaurant owner was sent to jail for 93 days for refusing to pay a massive fine, which was imposed on her by government officials literally making up decrees, all for the horrible crime of trying to operate and keep her business up and running. And of course, in Canada, a father was arrested, jailed for contempt after referring to his own biologically born daughter as she. Yes, I am not kidding you. The Attorney General of British Columbia, the man that you're seeing in front of your screen right now, a David AB, issued an arrest warrant after a father referred to his own biological daughter as his daughter and used the pronouns she. That is literally sending him to jail in Canada. Now, it's important to note here that this 14-year-old daughter does believe that she is a boy, and the Supreme Court of British Columbia, Canada ordered that this girl should receive testosterone injections without obtaining parental consent. The court also ruled that either of her parents refer to her using female pronouns to address her by her birth name, that they would be charged. Now they are charged. And again, this is a 14-year-old child who, after a school urged the girl to see a psychiatrist, the psychiatrist recommended the girl should begin taking hormones at 13, which started this entire legal battle, which in my opinion is absolutely absurd and shows you just how absolutely treacherous the state could be on your family. Expect this trend to, of course, increase, as of course we even have the mayor of New York City telling the NYPD to pay people home visits for, quote, hurtful comments. All of this as the NYPD, of course, promotes the use of armed robots on the street of New York City, as the police become more and more militarized, having more and more excuses to arrest individuals for basic things like calling your daughter, operating a business, engaging in a protest, jumping your cars on your own property, and accepting cryptocurrencies as a form of payment. What we're seeing right now is a literal police state being created right in front of our eyes, destroying our civil liberties, destroying our constitutional rights, all of course, while the real criminals are still at large, never facing the true ramifications of their horrendous, horrible actions that we can't even mention on this YouTube channel. So yeah, that's happening. Gee, I wonder why there's such a suppression of independent media. Huh. Oh, Why would that be happening? So yeah, as that happens, sincerely, thank you guys so much for being a part of this independent media broadcast. We are changed. Wouldn't it be possible if it wasn't for you guys watching, sharing, subscribing, being a part of LukeUncensored.com, and being a part of the conversation, which to me is the most critically important thing of all. Your comments, your feedback, really awesome. You being able to share this video, start the conversation, friends, family members, strangers walking down the street, double click this link, send it to them. It doesn't matter. Because you do, I'm still here, and I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you. And this is why. Love you guys. Stay tuned for more here on WeAreChange.org.